Hello, Libra. Thank you very much for tuning in to this week's read. For the main part of the read, I'm using the Light Seeker's Tarot, the Light Seer's Tarot by Chris Ann. It is a Chaos product. The H is over here on the side. Supportive Oracle Cards, Energy Oracle Cards by Sandra Ann Taylor. I believe this is Hay House as well. It says Lifestyles, but the H there makes me think it's Hay House. But if you look up the creator with the name of their deck, you should easily find what you're looking for. What do we have for Libra? Hiccup, apparently. Is that good, bad, or indifferent? Not worried about your card. Okay. The hiccup, I think, is because of what you're dealing with. All right, then I'm face down. Okay. Ooh, somebody made a decision. You might even have warned somebody. If you get involved in this, you're going to have to stay involved with this. I feel like you warned somebody. Because I'm getting like, they're going to choose something with the Nine of Pentacles, and right now they think they want it. This is their challenge card. They're choosing something, they think they want it. I think them doing this is going to leave something open for you, though. Because I'm getting they really don't want it. The thing is, when they choose this, it's going to move them out of this position with you. You warned them, though. I feel like this isn't bad for you. But at first, when I'm feeling this happen, it's kind of like, I warned them, and I didn't think this was right for them to do this. But because they made that choice, I feel like they're leaving. But I don't think this is bad for you. I think the trick of it is, this is not somebody you had a hard time with. This wasn't somebody that was difficult for you. But by them leaving, I do think something better is coming in. The thing is, I don't think you thought of them as bad anyway. And I'm not saying they were bad. But it's kind of like, you know, having a ham sandwich for lunch instead of, like, your favorite fried food. I don't know if I want to say that. But you know what I mean? Like, instead of having a ham sandwich, having something you really want. I'm not getting a good analogy for this. Because I feel like there's a ham sandwich leaving, but, like, this you know, hero tunnel, or, like, this sub is coming in, this something better, like, a really good meal is going to be here instead of a ham sandwich. Like, you could have had a ham sandwich for lunch, but instead you're having this great meal. And it's like, I didn't think a ham sandwich was bad for lunch, but the fact that there's something better here in front of me, I can't scoff at it. This isn't bad. I understand that. And I feel like you're still, like, you're at first you're kind of like, well, when you see this new thing coming in, you're like, I really didn't want the last one to leave, but it's fine. I'm getting, like, the person coming in needs your help. And how do you make an ally? You help somebody that deserves it, somebody who's going to be loyal to you, and there you go, you got your ally. Because somebody's, like, whoever ends up in this position, whoever, like, is taking this person's place in your life, they weren't expecting to do what they're doing, and they're having a hard time. I feel like things are just all over the place, and they just need somebody to say, hold on, before you keep running all over the place like a crazy person, how about we just pull it back, I'll help you do a couple things, I'll help you line this up, I'll help you prioritize things, and then this doesn't have to be a madhouse anymore. Because they're coming in with this Three of Swords energy, which just means they're tied up all over the place, and they don't know what to do, and they're having a hard time, they feel like they're failing, but I feel like this is somebody who's going to be locked in with you. It says contract, which kind of has this, it kind of has the Libra look to it right there. The lady, the justice lady, it does look like it. But it's not justice, it's contract. And I feel like this is somebody who's going to be a very, very strong ally. Because things are out of control for them. And they need somebody to slow them down. That's you. You're going to help them heal. The last person leaving, I feel like they're saying, don't center on that too much. There's nothing wrong. There's nothing bad. They just have to go. They're going to do their thing. There's no negative energy there. The person coming in needs help. You're helping them. You're helping them heal. they're going to appreciate it, and you have all these, you're going to be able to do a lot more with this new energy coming in. The last energy was not bad, so I don't want it to come across like the last energy was bad. The last energy was not bad, but this one, it's just like, it's so much more. This one is like somebody who, like, when you say this is how this should be, they're like, well, then it does. So how do we make it happen? That's this energy. The last energy, you might have been like, well, this is how this needs to be. They might have been like, well, explain to me why. Maybe, I don't know if I want to get involved with that. I mean, if you got to do it, you do what you got to do. That seems to be the last energy. The new one's kind of like, it needs to be how? Okay, then I'll help you. What do we need to do to make that happen? Okay. No, you say it needs to be that way, then that's how it needs to be. They're just like, whatever you say, okay, then that's how it needs to be. They're not even questioning it. Which is a lot of responsibility, but you can handle that. I don't see that being a problem. Because I see at first, you're kind of like, oh, wow. Like, they don't even question you. They trust you. Like, they got the Sun card for you. You help them out of a hard spot. As far as they're concerned, you have the answers. That's a lot. That's a lot, because I don't feel like you want that type of responsibility. I feel like you're just naturally going to explain why things need to happen the way they need to do. I feel like you're going to give them some extra information, and you're going to kind of say to them, be sure you want to do this. I feel like you're even going to say, you don't have to do it. You don't have to help me, but if you want to, this is why I think this should happen this way. But like, use your own inner voice to believe in what you're doing. Don't just do it because I'm telling you to. I think this is a good idea, and this is why. And they're like, yes, okay. Like, you got a really good ally here. They really believe in you. They feel like the way you look at the world makes sense. You feel like the way you look at the world makes sense, so what's wrong with that, right? What's wrong with that? Bond. Such a strong bond. Keep an eye on this only in the sense of, like, I feel like blind faith. It does make me a little uncomfortable. I feel like it's going to make you uncomfortable every now and then, because you might have to find a way to create, like, this energy of, like, you know, bring something up to them, see what they think before you tell them where it wants to go. You might have to kind of work it that way. Kind of, like, bring up a subject, get them to talk about it, see what they think about it, and then kind of, like, create a conversation about it before you tell them where you want it to go, just to see where they're going anyway. Because I feel like I don't want the responsibility of making decisions for this person. I don't like that. I feel blind faith here. Be aware of the blind faith. It's interesting because the Queen of Wands, she's very strong and she makes her own decisions, but this energy coming in is like, it's a very, like, this reminds me of a mother who believes in their child, and, like, you know, if their child wants to be an astronaut, they will move heaven and earth and go all 9 yards to make that happen. They will get the books, they will get the movies, they will take them to the, what do you call those places? The places with the shuttles. You know, they'll take them to museums, whatever they need to do. This is somebody who will go out of their way to make it happen. That's what I'm seeing for them, for this. Like, this person will move heaven and earth to support and help make happen what you want to happen. Be aware of it. I'm getting that it seems heavy, kind of like, just be aware of it. Because when you start moving something forward, they're going to pour the gas on that. Like, okay, let's make it happen then. Victory is here for you. I feel like that's one of the things we want to say with this. Like, this is like an ally. They're not going to push back. They're just going to be like, you want to, okay, let's do it. What, you want to go? Okay, I'm packing the car. You want to make a trip? We're going to do it. I'm ready. I already bought the tickets. Yeah, I'm ready to go. Let's go. Like, they're not going to question you. Be careful how you bring things forward, because you need to feel them out first. I think the blind faith, it makes me a little uncomfortable. You might be okay with it. I don't know. Just be aware of it. Because when you have blind faith, you don't have somebody checking you. You don't have somebody, like, pointing out, like, okay, you want to do this, but did you think about that? Did you think about this other thing? Like, okay, what if we go and the weather's not good? What if we go and this happens? This person isn't going to do that. You're just going to say, I'm going to do this. They'll go, okay, let's go. Be aware of it. Because you won't have that check and balance. In fact, I think for a lot of you, you might want to bring in a third person, or maybe even a fourth, so that you have that check and balance. You'll still have your ally who will always help you move forward, but you definitely want that check and balance. Not as somebody who's going to, like, get in your way, but somebody who will highlight things you're not seeing, because I don't see this other person doing this. They're just going to, like, whatever you say, okay. Okay. not bad. I know that's not bad, but, you know, they're just trying to give you a heads up. That way you have that check and balance to help you get forward in this. Just make it a little smoother, you know. Hope that came across right. All right, are we done? We're done. I'm going to shut this down here. I hope that helps. Thank you for watching. If you'd like a direct reading from me, shoot me an email, jamesforastral@gmail.com. That's jamesthenumber4astral@gmail.com. If you'd like to see the donation information, that's below as well. Thank you for watching, and you have a great day.